Colombia's defense minister Diego Molano formally accused the Venezuelan regime of being involved in a terrorist attack that was perpetrated in the Colombian border city of Cúcuta, in the airport of this city, which left many people injured and two police officers killed. During a press conference, Defense Minister Molano claimed that the terrorist attack was financed and planned from Venezuela. So, getting to this point, it is important to point out that to this day, Colombian authorities haven't blamed any single terrorist organization so far. Of course, the usual suspect, as always, are ELN and FARC, the two Marxist terrorist groups, the two Marxist guerrillas, the two Marxist Colombian guerrillas that have been planning and executing different types of terrorist attacks against the Colombian state over the last few decades. So, getting to this point, the pretty significant element is that according to different reports, in fact, according to intelligence report from the CIA and especially from the Colombian intelligence service, both groups are hiding in Venezuela with the protection of the socialist regime of dictator Nicolas Maduro. So, if one of these two terrorist groups were responsible for these terrorist attacks in Cúcuta, it is an undeniable fact that Maduro is also to blame, because we need to remember that Maduro is the one that provides full protection to both terrorist organizations. We're talking about the fact that Maduro has become Venezuela into some kind of safe haven for different terrorist groups, not only of Colombia, but also of many other countries around the world. We're talking about terrorist groups such as Hezbollah and even Hamas. In fact, different reports have been pointing out that Venezuela is the only country in the world where these two groups, Hezbollah and Hamas, work together in Venezuela, considering that the Maduro regime has provided safe haven. Of course, following this formal accusation from Defense Minister Diego Molano, his Venezuelan counterpart, Venezuelan Defense Minister Vladimir Padrino López, denied any type of involvement in this situation. Any type of involvement. Of course, he also claimed that it is a lie that the ELN and the FARC operates in Venezuela, when there is a lot of evidence and a lot of proof that, of course, confirms this claim. The fact that both terrorist groups are protected by the Maduro regime and operate freely and move freely in Venezuela. Of course, this situation represents a clear escalation in the Venezuelan-Colombian conflict. This is pretty delicate because this accusation from the Colombian defense minister, if these accusations are confirmed to be truth, this could be considered as an act of war, as an act of war from the Venezuelan regime to Colombia, considering that the Venezuelan regime is protecting and providing safe haven to Colombian terrorist organizations, which main goal is to attack the Colombian state and to overthrow the Colombian government. So we are going to see what is going to happen, but the truth is, the undeniable fact is that things are getting worse in the relationship between these two countries. Reporting from Medellin, Colombia, Luis Orozco, Newsweek.